नॉलेज इज पावर, नॉलेज इज कॉन्फिडेंस. नो मैटर विथ विच डिजीज यू हैव डायग्नोज्ड विथ एंड एट वॉट फेज ऑफ लाइफ, द करेक्ट वे टू डील विथ इट इज एडुकेटिंग yourselves. Actually, this should be the first step in every disease management and treatment protocol. We have already started educating our viewers on the topic of diabetes in pregnancy. We have already posted videos on what is gestational diabetes, how it happens, why it happens during pregnancy only, what are the impacts on the baby in the womb, what are the screening and diagnostic tests, and also the detailed procedures of GCT and GTT, those are glucose challenge test and glucose tolerance test. I am giving the links in the description of this video as well, you can check it out. Hello and welcome to Trupti Wellness. This is Dr. Trupti, and today we are going to talk on 5 areas where you need to focus to improve your diabetes or have a good control on your sugars during pregnancy. And the first point is walking. Ayurveda says that walking is the best technique to control diabetes. Acharya Shushruta has mentioned a specific word called chakramana, which means walking. Now every one of us know that walking is best exercise for pregnancy as well as diabetes. But the important point is how to walk and when to walk. So again Acharya Shushruta has mentioned that you have to walk on the grass and without footwear. You have to walk for 10 to 15 minutes after each main meal, that is after your breakfast, lunch and dinner. Also, if your sugar levels are not in control even after taking medications or insulin, then you have to walk after each meal of the day, that is even after your snacks. Exercise helps muscle to absorb blood sugar, preventing it from building up in a bloodstream. Now this effect lasts for only hours, so regular walking is important after every meal. This also helps and protects you from gaining that excess weight during pregnancy. What should be the speed of the walk? So here a term brisk walk is advised, which means you have to walk more faster than your normal pace. Approximately 1 kilometer in 10 minutes is considered as brisk walk. But you are in the phase of pregnancy and so you need to consider your comfort level as well. Generally, doctors or nutritionists advise to walk for 45 to 60 minutes in a day. But instead of going for a walk in a stretch of 30-30 or 40-40 minutes, you can break it into intervals and reap more benefits. The second point is division of meals in a day. Small and frequent meals after every 3 to 4 hours is very important to avoid the spikes and have a steady control. Considering this theory, you have to divide your meals into 6 meals per day, which contributes of 3 main meals, small to medium sized meals and 3 healthy snacks. Even Ayurveda says to eat as per the sunrise and sunset. So, the first meal of the day, that is your breakfast, should be within 1 hour after waking up. The next meal should be after 2 to 3 hours of your breakfast, that is your mid-morning snack. After that, again after a gap of 3 hours, you should have your lunch. That should be around 1 to 2 p.m. After 3 hours of your lunch, you have to take your mid-afternoon snack. That comes around 4 p.m. Next comes the dinner. Dinner should be more earlier and around the sunset time. This helps to maintain your pachan, that is digestion as well. And the last snack should be 1 hour before going to bed. That should be around 10 p.m. So in short, your first meal should be within 1 hour of the waking time and your last meal should be before 1 hour of sleeping time. The third thing is to practice the plate method. Portion control is very important in this disease. Now, how to calculate the contents and the nutrient composition of your diet? So let's check it out. Basically, your plate should contribute everything which includes carbohydrate, proteins, healthy fats and non-starchy vegetables. Now, the 50% of your plate should contain non-starchy vegetables. The 25% should be carbohydrates and the next 25% should be proteins. Now, this 50% portion of non-starchy vegetables includes your vegetable preparations and the salads. Ayurveda recommends to eat the vegetables from gourd families like bitter gourd, bottle gourd, ridge gourd, zucchini, cucumbers, pumpkin, ivy gourd. These are completely safe in pregnancy and are very good for a diabetes control. Along with this, it also advises to eat the leafy greens like fenugreek leaves, amaranth leaves, spinach, moringa leaves, which are very good for glucose control. In salads, you can have tomatoes, onions, cucumbers, radish, carrots, cabbage, lettuce, broccoli, and also the beet and peppers. Ayurveda specifically mentions to eat the vegetables of katu, tikta, and kashaya rasa, which means bitter, pungent, and astringent taste vegetables. The next 25% contributes of carbohydrates. Now your cereals, milk, and fruits comes under this category. Normally, people try to skip carbohydrates and focus more on proteins. But remember that proteins are heavy to digest and the digestion is already weak during pregnancy due to the hormonal imbalance. Ayurveda says that instead of skipping the whole grains, you can roast them first and then use it. For example, don't skip the rice, roast the rice and then cook it. Also, you can roast the wheat and then make the flour of the wheat and use it for your chapatis. Yerv or barley is the best you can have in this category as per Ayurveda. Also, oats and millets are the best option for this section. Regarding fruits, do not include fruits in the early morning meals and after sunset. The best time to include fruits in your diet is mid-afternoon snack. We will talk in more detail about fruits in our next point. Next 25% of your plate should be proteins. And the very first and common options when it comes to proteins are egg, chicken, meat and fish. No doubt these are good source of protein, but there are also veg proteins available which give you good nutrition along with the proteins. Here you can include cottage cheese, nuts, seeds, nut butters like peanut butter, tofu, hummus, etc. Ayurveda recommends pulses as a good source of protein which includes split dals as well as whole pulses. Horse gram or kulit is the superfood for diabetes as per Ayurveda, so don't forget to include this in your diet. With these, you also need to include the healthy fats in your diet like oils or the desi organic ghee like A2 ghee, butters, nuts, seeds, avocados, etc. Do we need to stop the sugar and sweets completely? So the answer is yes. You have to stop using white sugar, artificial sweeteners and ready-made sweets completely, even the jaggery. You can only have honey, as Ayurveda says honey is the best treatment for diabetes. The recommended dose is only 1 teaspoon of honey per day, that too either in the empty stomach early morning or after your meals. Now again, the honey should be pure and organic. Get it from the authentic sources and include 1 teaspoon of honey in the Panchamrit and take it as first meals of the day. The next point is select fruits wisely. Many people avoid fruits as they contain a lot of carbohydrates. But pregnancy is a phase where you need these fruits as it provides water, vitamins, phytochemicals and a lot of antioxidants, which is necessary for the growth of your child. Now, lot of them know that low GI fruits or low glycemic index fruits are good to have in diabetes as they do not give the quick rise in the blood sugar. But along with this, you need to also consider the glycemic load or GL of those fruits. Now, the glycemic load is amount of carb present in that food and how each gram of that carb is going to raise the blood sugar level in your body fluid. So portion control is very important in diabetic diet. This portion is also calculated considering the factors like BMI, associated medical condition and the stage of your diabetes. So always go for a customized diet plan for yourself from an expert doctor or the nutritionist. Do not go for any trial and error method, especially in the phase of pregnancy where each and everything is going to impact your child in the womb. And the last point is learn to manage your stress. High blood glucose levels and the stress hormone cortisol has a clear link. This is the recent study published in journal Psychoneuroendocrinology. Now, what are the ways to manage stress? So the first and very important is mindfulness meditation. These are the meditations which include dhyan like Sakshi Dhyan, body scan, which allow to accept the ongoing changes and face the present situation. Second is you need minimum 6 to 8 hours of sleep per day. Third thing is stop using gadgets late night as the light exposure on your eyes gives the wrong signal and interrupt your biological clock, which again interrupt in the hormonal secretion and trigger the pathology of diabetes. And the last point is listen some soothing music. Indian classical ragas are very effective in stress. Keep yourself engaged in some creative stuff or hobbies which will release endorphins in your body and keep your moods light. So these were 5 points from my side to improve your diabetic conditions in pregnancy. If you like the content, then please hit the like button and also share the video with the needy ones. If you are new to the channel, then please consider subscription. Let's meet in next episode. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Thank you.